Hello viewers, welcome back to Home Theater Guide and welcome to the first episode of Home Theater Basics. Basics, what? We are not kids to learn the basics, we know well enough. There is a possible way to think like this. So let me start from the another way. Have you recently purchased any home theater or TV or about to purchase? After purchase, your first action should be, you will open a website or YouTube to download a media file. Once it downloaded, you will play that media file on your TV or home theater or in your soundbar. After that, you will feel like this. Inside. Wow, check the picture performance. My TV is playing 4K media very smoothly and the picture clarity is rocking. My home theater is playing the Dolby and DTS audio tremendously. By listening it, I am into the action. Outside. Hey, nice clarity and nice picture. Decent audio clarity, right? Satisfied. Oh, okay. Let's talk about the truth. Have you downloaded a original 4K media file or is it been upscaled to 4K from 1080 pixel by using any software? If you say, yeah, I know, then happy. If not, in that same media file, audio is original or duplicate. Hey, I know, it's original. It's my guarantee. Okay, if it is original, who is the audio provider? Is it Dolby or DTS? Whomsoever it may be, at least do you know the channel information of that file? If you say, yes, I know, then happy. If not, then realize that you are cheating yourself. Just learn the basics, it will prevent you from cheating yourself or by someone else from outside. Let's start the basics episode 1. We'll talk about the video on our upcoming videos. First, we'll talk about the audio. Why? Because of audio is more important to a video. Try watching a video or movie without audio. Then how it's feel. So let's start the basics from the audio section. At first, by concentrating on sound and audio technology, one company went out to market, that is Dolby. On 1993, Ray Dolby has founded this company. On their early age, they concentrated on noise cancellation technology. Noise means you are listening this audio, right? In this room, acoustics and air has been disturbing my voice a lot. By cleaning all the disturbances in my voice will change like this. This is called noise cancellation technology. Based on this technology, Dolby has developed their first project to one movie. The movie is A Clockwork Orange on 1971. For this movie, Dolby has provided a single channel audio. Single channel is meant to be mono. Mono means single channel. By using Dolby noise cancellation technology, audio clarity got increased a lot as well as Dolby fame was also increased. It went into the next level, like Dolby is audio, audio is meant to be Dolby. Then they thought, what next? By the thought, they got an idea for two channel. Based on that, they created a Dolby stereo. Remember that, stereo is two channel, left and right, not 2.1. Yeah, they created a stereo on 1975. Then after stereo audio got super success. Why? Because of audio is getting separated left and right according to what we are watching on the screen and what we are observing on the screen. After stereo, Dolby image and their name increased to 10 times. Public got fixed that audio is meant to be Dolby. Simultaneously, public got realized that how important an audio for a video or movie. Dolby doesn't stop it there. Then they started research by the quote of what next. In that process, they came with an idea of multiple channel. They started research to create next generation audio technology to create an another revolution of sound. All these things are happening on one side. On the other side, someone was entering into the market. Like how boxers will enter into ring. Have you guessed who was on the other side? Yes, you are right. It was DTS, Digital Theater Systems. It was founded in 1990. After it got found, they started giving the huge competition to Dolby. From that time to till date. On that decade, both companies are having the same values and same market levels. One was an old one and another was newly started. It made a tie break in between them. At that time, both are having the same thought, multiple channel audio. Spoiler alert, you have to identify that both are doing separate and unique research. No one is not doing any copy like what we are doing on exams. By doing research on multiple channel channel, they finalized a 5-channel audio concept. In that concept, we have 3 channels on front, rest 2 on backside. How they designed these 5 channels and how it got transferred from 5 to 5.1, I am going to explain it by my own example. It's my own perceptual creation. For your better understanding, to make it easy, I was created an example like this. Do not believe these examples as a truth and do not argue with someone. I am not meant to discriminate any person or company in direct or indirect way. After they fixed on 5-channel concept, they might thought like this. People are watching movie on theater by directly facing on the screen. Whatever the action is going on the screen, audio should have to come from the first channel. So they fixed first channel. Then anyway, we have stereo. Whatever the audio coming from the left and right, it will separate. Now we have 3. Okay, if action is moving towards to backside, for the backs, we have 2 rear channels. Rear means backside. If it is on right, it would be right rear. If we apply the same on left side, it would be rear left. Like this, they got fixed 5 channels. After that, they got moved on to the next scene. On the next scene, there is an explosion going on. On that next scene, an explosion is happening. 5 channels got performed that very well. Everyone got satisfied. But there are some people who are not satisfied there. Those people were none other than our audio engineers. Then everyone asked that why. Then they replied that explosion is happening on the front side. We got the sound as well. Then simultaneously we got the same sound from the back sides. Good. But in all channels we are receiving the same kind of feel. We are supposed to get it from the front side, not from the all channels. Then they got realized on the deep research, they found that it caused due to the low frequency of sound. Okay, now we will try like this by removing the low frequency from the entire sequence, then we will play it back. Let's see how it would be. Once they started playing, everyone got shocked and everyone's mind got blown away. They didn't heard that much of crystal clear audio till now. They got the rich feel of sound. Then they done a small research on it and they found that as per the current speaker configuration, and they found that speaker design is not supporting the low frequency. Finally, they decided to create a one more channel for that low frequency sound. Actually, in our speaker, we have 3 parts. First one, tweeter and horn. And second part, mid-range drivers. And third part, woofers. Let's keep this speaker configuration aside. They decided to keep the low frequency on separate channel, right? As that 6 channel idea brought up. It's our subwoofer. Yes. Heart of your home theater. Without a sub, it's not a home theater. As the sub increased the sound clarity as well as richness of it. That's why it became the heart of your home theater. Everyone is happy right now that they created a 6th channel along with this 5th one. But few people are not happy. So far, those people are like me. Hey man, how it become a 6th channel? You guys have just removed the low frequency sound from the 5 channels. That's it. You didn't done anything. You didn't invented anything. You just separated the low frequency sound from these 5 channels. Then how it became the 6th channel? Like this, they fought with them and they modified these 6 channels into 5.1. Yeah, I mean 5 channels including one low frequency channel. So far everyone got clear on this, right? Then after creating 5.1, 2.1 had born. It was only introduced on the Dolby Digital and the DTS Digital. Before that, we have only stereo. Stereo meant 2 channel, not 2.1. Some people will try to cheat by saying stereo is 2.1. Be careful on that part. In these 2 channels, subwoofer won't come separately. I mean, it would be included in the left and right channels. As in 5.1, low frequency got separated as 0.1. By using the same scenario, they removed the low frequency from these 2 channels and they invented 2.1. 2 channels with one subwoofer. I mean, with one low frequency. Somebody will comes to you and says that this home theater or TV is very good and it can able to convert 2 channel into 5.1 and 2.1 will also support on this TV. You can buy this one. If anybody says these type of words, do not trust those words because it won't support like that. while you are purchasing any home theater or TV, salesman or any other person will try to say these kind of words to make you purchase that product. Stereo would not be converted as a 5.1. If the product is supporting like that, it definitely requires a Dolby or DTS authenticated significant signature drivers. I mean, Dolby or DTS should be a part of that manufacturer or support of that product. Then only it can do the conversion of stereo into 5.1 or 2.1 into 5.1. 5.1 got successfully created and released in the market. Low frequency got separated, sound clarity got increased, and richness is also increased. Excellent. That's why 5.1 will become the huge success on the market as of now. And also it became the core for the all upcoming audio codecs and audio channels. Everything is set right regarding to the 5.1 sound. Spoiler alert. Viewers, what I am going to say now is my own creation and own examples. Both companies are ready with their own 5.1 technology and waiting for the next project to showcase their innovation. Exactly on the same time, somewhere, one director is getting ready with his new script. And that script and concept is like, no one has any dare to shoot a movie with that kind of script and concept. But this director is ready for a dare. And the director approached to one of the company and explained his concept. So like this way, my movie is going to create a history in movie making and I required an audio track for this movie. After listening the director words, that company got realized that and they given a word to him like, sir, keep your hand on your heart. We have new technology and we will bring the life to your characters. It's our responsibility. Don't need to worry, sir. It's our honor. By saying these words, they end up with a deal. So far on the market, people are aware of stereo audio. No one hasn't experienced 5.1 yet. On this exact time, our director has released his new movie. Again, people are blown away second time. By the way, the movie is Jurassic Park. On 1993, it got released. Audio providers are DTS. Before this movie, in market, Dolby is meant to be sound and sound is meant to be Dolby. After releasing this, everyone thought that, hey, DTS came to market. There is a huge competition between DTS and Dolby. So let's see. After that, everything got changed. DTS came to the picture, then and a tough competition for the Dolby. So like this, Dolby and DTS came into market and went into the people's heart. Dolby was in the market from a while and DTS was started on 1990s. And 1993 is the huge milestone for DTS. It created its own revolution of sound and became a huge success on market. Oh my god, we discussed a lot. The first question which is rising on your mind is, how to find a media is original or a duplicate? So for that, I am here to help you out. Before going further, let me review it once. Mono means one channel, stereo means two channel, left and right. 5.1 means 5 channels with one low frequency channel. From here onwards, we have to check the channel information as well as codec information. Codec will represent the sound manufacturer and encoder. Dolby's 5.1 channel will comes with AC3 codec and DTS 5.1 channel will comes with DCA codec. Dolby's 5.1 channel will comes with AC3 codec and DTS 5.1 channel will comes with DCA codec. AC3 means active codec 3. DCA means DTS coherent acoustics. So far so good, the audio channel information would be like in a short form, like this. For 5.1, it would be 3F 2M LFE. 3F means 3 front speakers, LCR, left, center, right. 2M or 2R means rear channels and side channels. LFE means low frequency effect. Yeah, everything is fine, you given a good information. Then our question is, where can we find this information? Is that your question? It's very simple. You need to open your media file on your PC. Open any one of the application which you are using, like VLC, KMP or QuickTime, whatever it may be. Just search for an option called media information or codec information. I am using VLC. Here it is, media and codec information. After you open it, it will appear like this. Codecs and channel information will be available here. This representing that 5.1 audio and this is representing 7.1. Oh, I have given a lot of information for today. If you don't like my examples and information, don't hesitate to click that dislike button. In case, if you like, click that like button and subscribe for more videos. Hold on a minute. Got a good information, right? Why should we have to make delay to research and find the original and duplicate channel information on your media files? In case, if you are having all duplicate files, do you know how original sound would be like? If you taste a raw honey on your mouth, how sweet it would be. If you play the original audio on correct system, it would also give the same feel to your ears. Trust me, not believing my words? Want to try some original audio by downloading from the website? Why should you have to go and search for that? Come, we'll directly go to the Dolby's home and we will knock the door and we will ask for the original files. Link in the description. Enjoy the original audio. Stay tuned for my next video. Bye.